scripture I have to share with you this morning. It comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 9, starting at verse 24. Do you not know that in a race all the runners run, but only one gets the prize? Run in such a way as to get the prize. Everyone who competes in the games goes into strict training. They do it to get a crown that will not last, but we do it to get a crown that will last for heaven. Therefore, I do not run like a man running aimlessly. I do not fight like a man beating the air. No, I beat my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to others, I myself will not be disqualified from the prize. This is the word of God for us this morning. Today we are finishing a message series that we've been working on for, this is the fourth week, about small changes, big differences. And we've been talking about these small changes, small adjustments you can make in your life that will have a big influence on your life going forward. And kind of the way I wanted us to start thinking about that was think about someone that you admire, someone that you really look up to, that you think that they just have things together, and maybe it's in a certain area, and probably you think, well, I could never do that. I could never be like them. It's just too hard to do. It's too difficult. But really what I want us to recognize that probably they don't do something that's really hard or unattainable for anybody else. They probably do some small thing that goes unseen that has made that big difference in their life. An example might be if you look at a couple and you say they have the perfect marriage. They are just great as a couple, that everything goes well for them. I just love their marriage. I wish we could do that, but it's too hard for us. They probably have no big secret, but they may have some small secret, like every day they stop and they pray together with one another. And that time in prayer, just a short prayer with one another, changes their whole relationship. Or maybe there's other people that you look up to and you just think, I can't do the things that they do. I'm just not able to do that. It's probably just some small thing that makes a big difference. Maybe it's their Bible knowledge. You think, man, they know the Bible. They know it front to back. They know what God says in there. I really wish I could know God's word. They probably spend hours reading the Bible. And probably their secret is that they spend 10 minutes each day reading God's word. And it's through those 10 minutes each day that they are filled up with God's word and are able to know what God would say to them. And so it's not about doing these big, impossible, unbelievable things. It's about finding the small changes that will make a big difference in our lives. And first we start talking about our thoughts and our words, because we have our thoughts in our heads, and our thoughts become our words. Our words lead to our actions, and our actions take us to the destiny that God has before us. And so we talked about last week about capturing the destructive thoughts and words that we have, and then filling our minds and our words with the positive, peaceful, and eternal things of God, to put those God things into our minds and into the words that we used. This morning, I want us to look at our actions. How can we make a small change in our actions, add one action, take away one action that might have a big difference and make a world of difference in our lives? And changing our actions, changing our behaviors, take discipline. And I know we all love discipline, right? We love to be disciplined. We love to just do the things we need to do. How many of you are kind of disciplined people? You just always, you know, you're always ready to go. You know, you have these goals. You always achieve your goals because you try really hard. You work hard at it, and you always get done the things that you. Who here is really good at discipline? Really, really good at discipline. I see a half of a hand over there. There's a few. Okay. So how many of you? I won't make you raise your hands. Are in my ballpark, which is the undisciplined people. We're not so good at making our goals. We're not so good at sticking to things. We're just not disciplined. I've always just said, that's just the way I'm wired, you know? So I'm not disciplined. That's just the way God made me. And that's our excuse. That's our reasoning. Okay, I won't make you raise your hands on that one. But what I want to ask you to do, though, this morning is to maybe look at it a little differently. As I think about the things, the actions and behaviors that we have, what I want to tell you is I think we are all disciplined. We all are disciplined. It's just some of us are disciplined at the right things, and some of us are disciplined at the wrong things. We are disciplined in wrong areas, but yet we're still disciplined. Some of you are really good and disciplined at getting up early in the morning, you know, getting that workout in, spending some time with God, having a devotional, and you have a great day because you did all those things early in the morning. And others of you are very disciplined at hitting that snooze button. You just are very good at hitting that a few times in the morning. Some of you, I used to be so good, I didn't even have to look. I'd just go like this, and I'd hit that snooze button every time. I was so disciplined at it, I could do it really well. Maybe that's where some of you are. Maybe some of you are disciplined at eating healthy foods, and you choose the right things, and you don't ask for seconds, and all that kind of stuff. Others of you are disciplined to eat everything that's in front of you. You know, you see it, you eat it. This past week, I went to Marion. I have a small group of pastors. We meet monthly, and afterwards, we go out to eat. We went to a Chinese buffet over in Marion, and I got a plate full of Chinese food, sat down, and I ate it, and I was comfortably full. But I am so disciplined, I got back up, and I went to that buffet, and I got another plate of food, and I ate all that food that was on my plate. I'm so disciplined, I will not let food stay on my plate. I have to eat it all, and I got to get my money's worth at a buffet. And so that's a two-plate minimum for me. I'm disciplined at that, right? That doesn't help me lose weight or anything, but we're disciplined at those things. Another discipline I'm really good at, and Helen would attest to this, is if I'm watching sports on TV or a TV show, the kids can be screaming, Helen can be asking for things, I don't hear a thing. I just am disciplined on what I'm watching, and that's all I'm focused on. Afterwards, Helen said, didn't you hear me? I didn't hear your voice at all. I am just so disciplined that I can watch that show and not let things distract me. And so I want us to remember, we're all disciplined. It just depends on if we have the right disciplines or the wrong disciplines. And the way I want us to think about it is first we need to decide, what do we want most? What do we want most in life? Because most of the time we think about, what do I want now? And what do I want now doesn't always lead to what I want most. And so if we can start to recognize, what do I want most? And then what actions, what behaviors are going to lead to that? Then we can start to say no to some of the disciplines and the behaviors and actions we have that are responding to what I want now. Example, if you want to lose some weight, that's what you want most is to, cut a few pounds. Then, you have to say no to that donut that looks really good right in front of you. You have to say no to having large portions of food. And you just have to say no to a few things, change your discipline, change your behaviors a little bit, because you want to turn down what you want now for what you want most. And so this is what I think Paul is getting at in the passage I read from 1 Corinthians. I think Paul is telling the people in Corinth to work towards that prize, keep their eye on the prize, look at what they want most, not just what they want now. And the analogy he uses is running a race, as Jen kind of helped us to start thinking about running that race. And Paul is speaking to the people in Corinth, which he's speaking to the audience that he's talking to. Corinth was it was in an athletic community. Corinth is a city in Greece. Greece is where they started the Olympics, right? And they also had other games there in Corinth called the Isthmian Games. And they had this twice as often as the Olympics. They had the year before the Olympics and the year after the Olympics. It was very similar with races and kind of things. But the Isthmian Games was named for the isthmus that Corinth is on. Do y'all know what an isthmus is? Do y'all remember that from geography? It's just a narrow strip of land with water on both sides. Karen and I have a map up there of Greece, which I have kind of forgotten that Greece, is kind of a peninsula sticking out into the Mediterranean Sea. But that bottom, the southern part of Greece is just an island except for the isthmus of Corinth that connects it to the mainland there. And so twice every 4 years, they'd have the Isthmian Games, and everyone in Greece wanted to win those games. It was a very honorable thing in their nation to have won those games. And so twice every 4 years, people would come to Corinth, and they would train for the races. They would train for 9 or 10 months, and they had kind of camps that they would go to and train where the only good food was fed, to the runners. They gave them all the proper food, and they would train all the time. They even had, arenas where they could control the temperature, and so they would train in hot, hot temperatures in case it's a hot day during the race, and they'd train in cold temperatures in case it was cold that day. They wanted their body to be really trained and ready to go, that when the race started, they were ready no matter what. They were going to do it. And this is what Paul is speaking to. He says they strictly train for the races. He says, but all they get in the end is a crown of leaves, They run for leaves, but you run for a better prize. You run for a crown of life that God will give to you. God gives the crown of life to those who love him and those who live out God's purposes. And so that's the prize that we want to keep our eyes on. And that's what we want to run for, something we want most over something that we want right now. And so I want to encourage you to think about what Paul is talking about here. And what I want to ask you to do is not to go into strict training that'll take 9 or 10 months necessarily. I want you to pick one little thing, one little action, one little behavior, one little discipline that might make a huge impact in your life. If you can get a hold of that one discipline, that one action, it may change your whole life. And it's hard to find that one little action. I understand that, but I think God can lead you to that. The first question you have to ask is, what do I want most? Or what does God want most for me? And I believe that God will help us to do that, not to self-discipline ourselves, but to spirit-discipline ourselves, to allow the Spirit to tell us, here's what you need to be working on the most in your life. And then start to look at, all right, what behaviors, what actions can I do to move towards what I want most and maybe give up some of the things that I want now. What is it that you want most? Maybe it is that healthy body. Maybe you have some bad cholesterol or bad numbers or some extra weight that you want to get rid of. Then you got to start thinking, what little action can I do? Maybe it is getting up a little early and going for a walk. Maybe that little action can help move things in the right direction. Maybe it's not asking for seconds. Whatever it is, what's that one little action that you can do to help reach you towards what it is that you want most? Maybe there's some financial struggles you're going through and you always are worried about finances. Maybe that financial peace is what you want most. Then what one little action can you do that will help lead to what you want most? Maybe it's saying no to some things you want to buy, some temptation buys, in order to know, I want to be debt-free and have the peace that I can have when I get there. So I'm going to change some things I do now in order to get to what I want most. Maybe it's some relationships. Maybe God would put a relationship on your heart and mind, maybe a relationship that needs some forgiveness. And your action might be, you know, instead of thinking about that person and wanting revenge or feeling hurt, maybe when I think of that person, I just need to pray for them or I need to pray for me. And I'm going to turn to prayer instead of that anger and revenge. That's the action that I want to take in order to heal that relationship. Or maybe there's another way to connect with someone. Maybe it's with your kids or your parents or friends or spouse. You know, many spouses, you know, we get so busy with the kids and everything else that we forget about the person that we should be dating too, you know. And maybe one, your small action would be, we're going to go on 2 dates a month, you know. That's what I'm going to, that's the little action I'm going to take is I'm going to say twice a month we're going to go on a date. Maybe you need 4, maybe you need 8, you know, whatever. But find your small thing that will help you get to where you want to go. Maybe what you want most is just a better relationship with God. Maybe you just want to get closer to God. What small action can you take that can help lead to that? As a congregation, we believe that we are called to see Christ and to show Christ to other people, and we do that by being here on Sunday mornings to embrace Christ and worship. We are committed to getting into a small group so you can experience Christ with other people. And we're committed to serving Christ in ministry. And so maybe one of those three areas you haven't fully stepped in yet. And God might say, just take a little step there. Just find one thing that you can do to move in the direction of those things. And with Lent starting Wednesday, as I said, it's a great time for us to think about our faith journey and the race that we're running there. And maybe just commit for during Lent, the 40 days of Lent, I'm going to do this one thing. I'm going to, you know, every time our family's in town, we're going to be at church. Every time we're in town, we'll be there. We'll make that a commitment. Or maybe, you know, it's a great time to start a small group. We're going to have a small group starting the focus of our Lenten time, which is the 7-mile miracle. And so maybe you want to join into a small group. That'll be going. And just do it for those 7 weeks. Just do it during Lent. Or maybe it's finding a ministry to serve in. A month from today, we're going to have our service Sunday, which is where we gather. Instead of having worship service here, we worship God by going out and serving the community. Maybe you've missed that and you say, you know, this year, I'm going to do that. I'm going to sign up for a ministry and I'm going to give that one Sunday morning in order to serve people in Jesus' name. Find that one little thing that can make a big difference in your life. And I believe as you go to God in prayer, he'll help you to see more clearly what it is that he wants most in your life and help that to happen. For me, as I've been kind of praying through this and working on it in my own life and talking with my small group on Wednesday mornings, kind of the thing that God laid on my heart is what I want most is just to be a great dad. You know, I want to be a dad that's there for my kids and teaching them about Jesus and all those kind of things. And I don't always do that the best that I can. Or I feel I should do better. And so that was the best that God kind of placed on my heart. And I was like, God, how can I get better? What can I do to improve in this area? And what one little action can I do? And God said, ask your kids how you can pray for them. Just once a week, ask each of them, how can I pray for you today? Or what can I pray for you? And the responses, I've done it for 3 weeks now, and the kids, sometimes it's serious and sometimes it's humorous what they say when you ask them, how can I pray for you? But it always is something that I wouldn't have gotten if I hadn't asked that question to them. But the bigger thing to me is to let them know that I'm praying for them, like that song that you guys just finished with there. You know, I've been praying for them for a long time. They need it, and being raised by me. But, you know, God just said, let them make sure they know. They may have thought I was praying, but I want them to know their dad is going to their Heavenly Father and on their behalf. And lifting them up. And so doing that every week, I hope that, you know, down the road, they'll always know dad's praying for me. No matter what's going on, they have a bad day at school, something just doesn't go their way, I know dad's praying for me. And that's what I want them to know. And so I think that one small thing, just asking that question once a week, is going to make a big difference. And I believe God will lead each of you to that one thing also. If you just take the time to ask him, God, what do I want most? What do I need most in my life to live out my faith? I think God will speak that to you. And you say, what one action, what one little behavior, what discipline can I adjust in order to make that happen? And I believe God will share that with you as well. But talk with other people too. Small groups are great at helping you do that as well. But there is a small thing that God has for you to do, some action or behavior, some discipline to have or discipline to get rid of that will make a big difference in your life. I don't know what it is, but I know God does. And I believe not in self-discipline, but spirit discipline, that God will help you find that place. And so as you run the race of life, I pray that God will just lead you and guide you, not to the things you want now, but the things that you want most, the things that will make a huge difference in your life by just some small change that you can choose to make today. Let me pray for you. Gracious God, I just lift up these people here. Each one has something in their heart, something in their mind. Maybe it's something that has seemed too big for them in the past, and they've said, that's never going to change. I can't change. I can't do it. Lord, lift that up to their heart and mind and say, maybe they can't, but God, you can. God, you've been waiting to do a miracle in their life if they would make one small change to their actions, one change to their behavior and their discipline, that they would choose what you have most wanted for them instead of what they see and want now. Continue to fill them with that, Lord, and guide them as they run the race. Help them keep their eyes on the prize. We pray this all in Jesus' holy and precious name. Amen.